God is in control. Thank you, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, God. Yes, God. This means war. Thank you, God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, God. for things of God. Hallelujah. Don't take it lying down. Amen. Yeah, it's me, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Don't give him your praise. Amen. Your praise belongs to God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. We bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Thank you for the blood of Jesus Christ. We bless the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
For all that he's done and all that he's going to do in our lives. Amen. He's worthy, worthy to be praised. Yes, he is. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. He's God and God all by himself. Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah, Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you praise right now, God. We bless your name for all that you've done in our lives and all you're about to do. Father, let the words of our meditation and the meditation of our heart be acceptable, God, in your sight. You are our Lord, you are our strength, and you are our Redeemer. We know that you're here with us, God, because you said if there's two or three gathered in your name, that you'll be in the midst. So we thank you for your Holy Spirit right now, God, that it's leading us and guiding us to all truth and righteousness. It's in the name of Jesus that we pray. Thank you for this word that you've given us, God, and we are expecting a great move of you, God. Let the children of God say amen.
Amen,
amen, amen, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you for being obedient. Amen, and going to the table and grab something off the table. The Lord God Almighty instructed me to tell you guys to do that. Amen. So now you want to know, what does that mean? Amen. On the things that you have taken off the back of the table. Amen. You know, we're starting a new series today. I thought God was going to let us come back and with a part four of it, but God gave me something different to start today. Amen. The topic or the theme today of this particular series is God teach us how to pray. Amen. God teach us how to pray. As I was driving, that's what God gave me. But this little exercise has a really good significant meaning behind it. Amen. I've noticed some of the things that you picked up. You picked those things up, I would think, in a necessity is one. Two, it's something that you're comfortable with. Amen. It's something that you have used many times over and over and over again. I was thinking when I picked up the little bowl, I said, well, we got dog lovers all in the church, so I better get more than one. Amen. We need that when we're feeding our dogs, our animals. We need something to put it in. Amen. We don't just throw it on the ground. Why? Because we love them. Amen. We care for them. Amen. We want the best for them. Amen. And God see us the same way. Amen. When we're praying to God, it's nothing different than what we do every day. God, we have to depend on God in prayer every single day, all throughout the day, all the time. Amen. Y'all heard me say this many times about leaning not to your own understanding. But this thing, this prayer, this thing that we do, we realize that it's many things, but to us, it's an open channel to God. Amen. But then I seen one person picked up a hammer. And then I heard somebody say, it's just a hammer. They said, no, it's more than just a hammer. Amen. There's many hammers out there that you can buy from the hardware store. Amen. But for people who's not a builder, you may go pick up the cheapest one, and that hammer have you hitting on the nail 16 times. You're like, thing him, they ain't doing nothing. Just bouncing back and forth. Amen. But having the right tool for the job. If you're a builder, you want the right tool. That's just like prayer. When we're praying to God in the right way. Prayer is a tool. Amen. It's our communication. It's what we do when we're talking to God about whatever we need to talk to God about. Amen? So I seen some picked up, and I was funny about this. I'm like, why would this person pick up a 5 foot level? I ain't never seen them build nothing before, but I guess they thinking that they gonna be a great builder. Amen? They wanna make sure everything is level and plumb and straight. Amen? Nobody picked up the computer. I would have thought somebody would have picked up. Somebody got it? All right. Okay, so somebody did grab the computer. I would have thought that somebody else would have grabbed that, but they didn't grab it. They was thinking about something else. Amen? I ain't going to call no names out. I ain't going to call y'all like that. Y'all know who I'm talking about. Amen? But I look back there. I see a colander back there that's still back there. Amen? That was just something human that I thought of, you know, but if you're cooking and you're making some spaghetti, you're going to drain some noodles, you need a colander, amen? There's no need to try to pour them in the sink and then try to get them back out, because that just don't work, amen? Having the right tool. So what you talking about? I'm talking about simply having the right tool for the job will almost and 100% guarantee the right results. Hello, walls, amen? Amen. I saw one picked up the Bible, amen? That was good. I even saw one picked up some oil, amen? Having the right tool. But that's just half the battle. Using it in the right context, the proper way, amen? There's no reason for me to grab the computer, get it before a nail, and start beating on it with the computer. That ain't how that works. Am I right? Amen? There's no need for me to go to the dog with a ham in my hand talking about let's eat. He's not going to eat that. Amen. So when it comes down to praying, God say we have to know how to pray. And when we pray, expect the right results. Hello, walls. Amen. So that brings us to, we got a couple of scriptures we're going to bounce around, but let me give you these. It's going to be 2 Chronicles 7:14 is going to be one. And this is a lot. This is a lot on this. I don't know when God's going to take us off of this, because it was just so much I had to pick, just to get us started off, to get us thinking, amen? And I go back to some other things that y'all picked up. We'll talk about those. So y'all got that wrote down? Mm-hmm. Psalms chapter 5, verse 1 through 3. Jeremiah 29. I think I'm going to start at 11, 12, and 13. Amen. And then Matthew chapter 6, 5 through 13. Amen. It's going to be my closing. But you know there's going to be some more, but these are the ones we're going to start with today, if that's all right. Amen. So God teach us how to pray. Amen. I saw one that grabbed some what you call the things when you're grabbing the hot pots? Pot holders, yeah. I saw somebody grab those. Amen. When you coming from the stove going to the counter, you ain't got the proper tool in your hand gonna get burned. You gonna drop it. Ow, that's hot. Drop it all on the floor. Then you got to clean up the floor. I saw somebody grab some spoons. Amen. You got those nice, pretty, name some people that make pots, because I got some of them Rachel Ray's. I like them Rachel Ray's.
Martha Stewart.
But I like them Rachel Ray's. So when y'all spend all that money to buy those pots, you don't want to take no metal spoon. Oh, okay, y'all know what I'm talking about. And when you look in the bottom, you got a big old racetrack line down in there. So I saw somebody grab the right spoon, amen, so you don't want to mess up those pots, amen, it's important, amen. Oh, okay, I'm trying to figure, I seen somebody grab the, what's it called, the little cups, or measuring cups, when you got all the different cups when you're baking, amen. If you like me, I like to bake a little bit, y'all. Isn't that's funny to y'all? But you got to have the right tools, amen. Don't tell me to put a quarter of a cup or something, and I don't have a quarter of a cup. I'm a measure. Just pour it in there. Ain't gonna come out right, is it? So y'all know what I'm talking about. God teaching us how to pray. So it brings us to our first scripture, amen. 2 Chronicles 7:14. God saying, if my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and will heal their land. Amen. So our praise and worship songs with this one was adoration, was worship songs to our God. And we were just thanking God for what he had already done. Amen. But we are humble. We're not proudful. We're not the people that try to be arrogant and rude and haughty. Amen. The Bible said if you exalt yourself, God will humble you. But if you humble yourself, God will exalt you. Amen. So the Bible also says God resists the proud. Amen. He don't like you being that way. So being humble, amen, coming before the Lord with a thanksgiving heart, amen, and seeking God's face and praying to God, amen, what God is going to do. He's going to hear from heaven. You say, God, how can you hear from heaven and you're in heaven? I'm glad you asked. Amen. When we pray, we always pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Do we not? Amen. God sent his only begotten son down from heaven. Amen. To show us, to teach us how to pray to the Father. If we praying in any other way other through his son Jesus, that's not the right way. Amen. His son Jesus, the Holy Spirit, is with us where? On this earth. Amen. They're all in one. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. So God is telling us through his son Jesus, he can hear from heaven, amen, and forgive us for our sins. And then he will heal the land. Proper tools. Proper way to pray. Amen. You see the importance of the saints of God? So it brings us to Psalms chapter 5. Amen. You say, now you know, which you already knew, that everything you do has to be in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. You got to pray with a humble heart, a submissive heart, not a heart that's being haughty. Well, let me say this for why y'all flipping to Psalms 5. You can't ask God to kill somebody because they have offended you. You can't go to God and say, God, you know, I'm really just not liking what they said or what they did. So would you please kill them by next Thursday? The world would be in a better place if they wasn't even here living. Amen. I can do so much more if they wasn't here. What kind of prayer is that? Amen. The word of God says you have to pray for those that despitefully use you and say all manner evil against you falsely for God's name's sake. Amen. So when you're praying to God with a humble heart, make sure your prayers are going in the right way to God. Make sense? Psalms 5 and 1 says, give ear to my words, O Lord. Consider my meditation. Amen. Give ear. God, can you please hear what I'm saying? While you're hearing them, God, consider them. Amen. Make sure that when I'm praying to you, Father, it's in the right way. I'm directing my prayers to you. Amen. With a submitted heart. Amen. A humble heart to God. Amen. So when you think of that, think about when you're using your words, you know how things was established here on this earth and before time. Amen. Everything was established with the word. Amen. Everything was established through communication back and forth. Amen. We can think about before we really had a whole bunch of money, how our word was our bond. If I tell you I'm going to do something, then that means I'm going to do it. Amen. If you tell me you're going to trade me for doing what I did for you, then that's what it's going to be. So we realize the importance of our words. Amen. Consider our words. Amen. So therefore, when we're praying to God, we have to realize that God will do just that. Consider them. Amen. He said in his word, he said, remind him. Bring him in remembrance of his word. So when you pray, use the word of God. Amen. Not your own words. Think about some of you that are married. Amen. The words was exchanged. You exchange your vows through the man, the woman of God, whoever it was. Amen. That did the ceremony. But words was exchanged. Same as prayer. Amen. We're exchanging words from ourselves to God. Amen. You think about how law was established. Amen. How agreements or records, how they was established, amen, through words. Well, what about while we're here? What about the word of God? What about our faith? What about our confession? Amen. It was established through words. He said, if you confess with your mouth, believe in your heart, then you should be saved. Amen. That's a prayer. I'm praying that God hear me confess with my mouth and God will accept that and save me. Hallelujah, walls. Amen. Pray. Teach us, Father. Amen. Hearken unto the voice of my cry, my King, my God. For unto thee will I pray. Amen. Hear. That's what he's saying. You're saying, hearken, hear. Hear my cry. Hear my voice. Who is the King? God is the King. The King of glories. Who is God? God all by himself is God. Amen. I, who is I? That's you. Who are you going to pray to? God. We finished up last week talking about those small g gods, amen, about idol worshipers. We don't pray to those. We pray to the true and living God, amen, because he can do what? He can hear us. He's the only one that can do something about what we're asking him to do, amen. So he will hear. My voice shall thou hear in the morning, O Lord, and in the morning will I direct my prayers unto thee and will look up. Amen. As you waking up in the morning like you always do before your feet hit the floor, you always look up and just tell God, thank you just for another day. Amen. Before you roll out the bed and you want to just thank and love on God for what God has already done, how God has allowed you to see a day that you've never seen before, a whole brand new day. I'm not saying it's not without challenges. No, I'm not saying it's not without difficulties. But yet we still would direct our prayers to who? To God. Amen. In the morning, in the evening, throughout the day, all day, and all night. Now, why are you looking up? What are you looking up for? What are you watching for? What are you waiting for? You're waiting on God to answer you. Amen. You're waiting on God to bring your prayers to light, to honor your prayers, to allow you to see the manifestation of what you're asking God. Amen. Always pray the will of God for your life. You don't ever want to be out the will of God. You may have an ideal, a thought, and a desire, but if that's not God's will for your life, then guess what? Walk past that. Amen? Look up and wait for God to do what? Bring it to pass, what you're asking him. Amen? Jeremiah 29 and 11. We have to pray without ceasing. Sometimes, even as we're praying, we don't even have to open our mouth, amen, to have to hear a verbal word that's being spoken. You say, well, how can you do that? Pray within your inner man, amen. You can be sitting there quietly at your desk while you're working and thinking about the goodness of the Lord, but yet you're still praying. You're still communicating to your God, amen. You think about those that can't even hear or can't even talk. So you don't think they pray to God? They do pray. Amen. And God does hear them and answer them. Amen. Jeremiah 29 and 11 say, God says, for I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Thoughts. Amen. So if the enemy is bringing to your mind, telling you that God is not really pleased with you, or God does not hear your prayer, and you know how you like to stand before you and say, well, how can you pray? You just committed an offense against God. Yes, I may have. You may be absolutely right, but I still can pray. Amen. Don't let an offense stop you from trusting God when you pray. Amen. Because God don't see you as the offense. That's just an offense. It's just a sin against God. Amen. God see you as something greater than that. Amen. You are his only child that he has. He loves you with all his heart, with all his soul, with all his mind. Amen. So don't let the enemy tell you you don't have a right to pray to God. Amen. Because of an offense. Amen. So God is telling you it doesn't matter. The thoughts that he has for you are peace and not of evil. And to give you an expected end. Then shall you call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. Look at that word again. Hear. Amen. Pray without ceasing. Call on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Because he's yet omnipresent. He's always with you. He never will leave you nor forsake you. He hears you, saints of God. He want to hear from you. We had this sermon before, saints don't stop praying. Y'all remember that? You should always want to pray. You should always want to talk to your God. Amen. Don't take matters in your own hand. Don't think that this is something, whatever you may be battling, that you can do it, that you can fight it, or you can make it better, you can change the situation. We can. That's why we pray to God. Amen. That's why we seek God's face. Amen. Because we trust the God whom we serve. And ye shall seek me and find me when ye shall search for me with all your heart. Your whole heart. Amen. You say, well, I am. I'm glad that you are. But can't nobody tell it like you can tell it. Amen. Are you wavering like James talked about in chapter 4 about a double-minded man being unstable in all his ways? You searching God and seeking God with your whole heart. Not your heart that pumps blood throughout your body, but your spiritual heart, your every fiber that's in you. Amen. Throughout the day, do you not ever get enough of God? You find yourself just loving on God in every area of your life because you know without God that you wouldn't live. Your Lord, your Savior has your life in his hand. Amen. Goes back to the thoughts that he have. Amen. You may be dealing with some sickness or disease, but that shouldn't stop you from seeking and searching God with your whole heart. Amen. So keep doing it, saints, is what I'm saying. Keep praying to the Father with your whole heart. You make a confession with your mouth, with your words, and God will answer you. Why? Because he hears you. Amen. God is not slumbering, nor is he asleep. Amen. So that brings us to Matthew 6 and number 5. Amen. Y'all enjoying this? Amen, Wallace. Matthew number 6. Amen. So God is awesome. He's a loving God. Because he first loved us, now we can love him. We're going to begin at Matthew chapter number 6, verse number 5. Amen. And when thou prayest, thou shalt not be as the hypocrites. Amen. Or, for they love to pray standing in the synagogues and in the corners of the streets, that they may be seen of men. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. Amen, Walls. You don't have to stand on the corner. We talked about this, about wearing a shirt saying that I'm a Christian. I'm not opposing that. I'm not against that. Amen. But the Bible talking about letting your light shine before men that they may see your Father in you. Amen. And glorify him which is in heaven. But there's nothing wrong with that. But if you sitting there and you wearing this shirt, but then your deeds and your action are not backing up with what you're wearing, then you're a hypocrite. Your reward is, I'm a preacher. Yeah, I preach down at the church, but guess what? How much am I preaching? Charity begins at home before it can be spread abroad. How I'm going to tell you to do something that I'm not willing to do myself. Amen. Don't be a hypocrite. You don't want that to be your reward. Amen. He says, but when thou prayest, enter to that closet, and when thou hast shut the door, pray to the Father which is in secret, and thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly. Amen. Where is your closet? Now, he's not literally saying that you have to get in a closet, but some people do, because I do, and I like to do that. Sometimes you need to steal away in your closet. Amen. You need to be in a place that is only you and God. That's your closet. Amen. You could be driving down the street in your car, in your truck. Amen. Let that become your closet. When you pray to your Father, you already say you done searched your heart. Now you know that when you pray to God, you ask God, that God definitely hears you. Amen. The enemy can't deceive you or fool you to the point to think that God does not hear you. Now you're seeking, and now you're talking to your Father, because God hears you and God will reward you. Where? Openly. Amen. You don't need to stand before anyone and say, you know, I'm really upset because you didn't put me on your program. I really wanted to pray. You should have put me on your program. Is that in secret? That's open. That's as the hypocrites do. The Bible talk about your gift will make room for you. Amen. If you seeking God in season and in out, day and night, secretly, God will reward you openly. Amen. Amen. I love to say this. If you're not a praying person, guess what? It's going to show up that you're not a praying person. Amen. You can't get behind God's and to get in front of God's people and pretend to be something that you're not. Amen. Amen. God will let it come to light. So 7 says, but when you pray, use not vain repetition as the heathen. They do, for they think that they shall be heard of their much speaking. You say, well, I don't do that. I'm glad you don't. You know how we said before, say when we pray to God, after we pray, we leave it at the altar. Now we begin to thank God for what we prayed. Simply, God is saying that you don't have to repeat over and over and over and over to God in your prayers. When you ask God for something one time, leave it right there. You begin to thank him on that. Amen. Even though it has not manifested here on this earth, you begin to walk in faith and you have the victory. Lord, I thank you that you heard my prayers, and I'm waiting for you to give the increase. I'm waiting for you, God, to give the answer. Amen. Doesn't matter if it come today. Doesn't matter if it come tomorrow. Doesn't matter if it come next week. God, I'm still yet going to trust you. Amen. Why? Because I'm praying to you with my whole heart. Amen. I'm humbly submitting myself unto you. And you already told me the thoughts that you have for me are good and not of evil. Amen. So evil does not come from God. We know who that comes from. Amen. So walk in assurance in that when you pray. Amen. Be not, verse 8 says, be not ye therefore like unto them, for your Father knoweth what things ye have need of before you ask. Amen, Walls. So God, you really do know that I don't have all that I need right now? Sure, I know. You really know that I'm standing at the crossroad today and I got a decision to make? If I don't have this done by the close of the day, something is going to happen? Sure, I know. You're not going to do anything about it? Sure, I am. Haven't you already prayed to me about that? Trust me. Amen. I will provide. David said it, what he said. He said, I was once young and now I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken, nor his seed begging bread. Amen. What Job said, though he slay me, yet I'm still going to trust him. God giveth and God taketh away. Amen. The earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof, and they that dwell therein. I know all things. Is there anything, y'all heard me say this, is there anything hid up under the sun from God? Nothing. God knows all things. Amen. He know what we have need of even before we ask. Amen. What is the need? What is the need? What is the need? What is the need when it comes to God? It's not a need. God doesn't need anything. God can speak it and bring it to pass. Amen. His words Heaven and earth will pass away, but his word will do what? It will not fall. Every word that he spoke, it surely will come to pass. Hello, walls.
Amen.
9. After this manner, therefore, pray ye, our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Now, he's telling us what to do. This is something that we're going to begin to do in this house. Amen. We're going to pray like we've been praying, giving God an adoration of thanksgiving. But afterwards, we're going to begin to pray this way. Why? Because we want the results. We want the right results. So we're going to use the right tool. Amen. And this is the tool that God instructed us to use. Amen. Hallowed, our Father, which is in heaven, our Father. Hallowed be thy name. Only name that it is our Father. Amen. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on in earth as it is in heaven. What is that kingdom? Who is that kingdom? That kingdom is in heaven, that glory, amen. Jesus told him when Jesus was walking with his ministry, he said, my kingdom is not of this world. Amen. So it's in glory where his Father is, where our Father. But his kingdom will become on this earth, amen. He said, give us this day our daily bread. There go that need. Amen. He provides for the birds, the bees, the trees, everybody. If he provides for them, he'll give us our daily bread. Amen. And forgive us. Now, here's the really good part. And forgive us of our debts as we forgive our debtors. So when you pray, if you won't forgive others, will your Father forgive you? Praying the right way. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. If ye forgive men of their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you when you pray. But if ye forgive not men of their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. Y'all done heard me say this. All have sinned and came short of God's glory. Amen. But you don't have to stay there. Forgive yourself. Walk in forgiveness. Forgive others when they offend you. Amen. Let it run down your back like a duck in the rain. Don't even worry about that. So when you're praying to your Father, he can hear you and answer you. It's just that serious. Amen. So in my closing, saints of God, as we're moving about this week, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and 17 says, pray without ceasing. Don't stop praying. Amen. You continually to talk to your God as you're moving this week. And if you need to ask God to forgive you for your trespasses, then you need to ask him. And if you need to ask somebody to forgive you, then you need to ask them. Amen. You don't want to stand before the king and God say, well, listen, you got an ode in your heart against your brother. Go lay that prayer. Go lay your gift at the altar. Go back to him and ask him to forgive you. And then come back. And then I will hear you. Amen. We don't want to do it in reverse. We're going to do it the right way the first time. Please forgive me. If I said anything or done anything in a way that God is not pleased with, or I offended you, will you please forgive me? I really didn't mean it that way. I didn't mean to hurt you. I didn't mean to say it to make you feel any certain way. And begin to walk away from that. Amen. Now let me warn you before you begin to do this. The enemy is going to come. And you're going to hear that broken record in your spirit. And you're not going to be able to turn it off. Why? Because you're not even playing it. He's playing it. Nah, God don't love you. Ah, that wasn't no real apology. Nah, you should have did it this way. You should have gave him everything in your pocket. Give him the deed to your house. Give him your car. That's a real apology. Don't pay no attention to that. Amen. You search your heart. You do what God put in your heart to do. So when you're praying to your Father, God will hearken unto your prayers. Amen. Your communication. Be blessed. May God be with you. And may heaven smile upon you. There will be a part two to this. Amen. 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 Father, we thank you for this word. And we thank you for your Holy Spirit. Just leading us and guiding us to all truth and righteousness. It's in the name of Jesus. Thank you, God, that you're teaching us that we need to pray in the right way so you can hear us, God, and answer us. Everything we do and say, Father, is in the name of Jesus. Let the saints of God say amen. Amen.